friends, I'm Megan.
And my name is Jesse. Hey, Megan, I really like your crown, but why are you wearing it?
I'm wearing a crown today because today's Bible story is one of my favorites. It's about a brave queen named Esther.
Wait, there are kings and queens in the Bible?
Yes, Jesse, kings and queens.
That's amazing. I bet Queen Esther's crown made her so brave and she was never scared of anything.
Well, it wasn't a crown that made Queen Esther brave, Jesse. God heard Queen Esther's prayers for God's people and he made her brave.
But why was she scared in the first place? If she's the queen, she should be able to do whatever she wants.
Well, there was a man who worked for the king, and he wanted to hurt God's people. Queen Esther had the chance to help rescue God's people, but the only way she could go talk to the king was if she was invited. Let's listen to our Bible story to see what happened. Some of God's people were in a land called Persia. Persia was ruled by King Ahasuerus. The king chose Esther to be his queen. Esther was one of God's people who were called Jews. Esther did not tell the king that she was a Jew. One day, Esther's cousin Mordecai heard some bad news. Haman, one of the king's helpers, had a very evil plan to destroy the Jews. Esther wanted to help her people, but the king had a rule. No one can go to the king unless the king asks that person to come first. If anyone broke the rule, the punishment was death. The only way to not be punished was if the king held out his scepter. That meant you may live. Esther was afraid. Mordecai reminded Esther that she was a Jew. Maybe Esther had become the queen just for this time, so she could save her people. Esther asked all the Jews to not eat or drink for 3 days. Then Esther went to the king. He saw Esther and held out his scepter. That meant she would live. "What can I do for you?" the king asked. "I will give you anything, up to half of the kingdom." Esther asked the king and Haman to come to a feast. When they were done eating, the king said, "What can I do for you?" "I will give you anything, up to half of the kingdom." Esther said, "Come to my feast tomorrow." The next day, the king and Haman went to Esther's feast. When they were done eating, the king said, "What can I do for you?" "I will give you anything, up to half of the kingdom." Esther said, "There is a plan to kill me and my people." "Who made that plan?" the king asked. "This evil man, Haman," Esther said. The king was angry. He ordered Haman to be taken away. Then the king made a law to keep the Jews safe from their enemies. God's plan was to send the Messiah into the world through Abraham's family. Haman's evil plan could not stop God. God had a plan for Esther to rescue his people. By saving the Jews, God made the way for his son Jesus to come into the world.
Produces a repentance that leads to salvation.